You already know how big and useful ChatGPT is, but you probably don't know these hidden prompts and formulas that you really need to know to use it to its full potential. The ChatGPT is very good at writing essays, but with these formulas you're simply enabling the God mode. This represents what ChatGPT actually sees in the background and can be very useful to you too. First, you specify the length you want, then result, the topic, and finally the style. The length is pretty obvious, just write the number of words you need. The results represent the type of content you want. It can be an essay, an article, a song, a script, or similar. The topic is what you want it to be about. And in the end, you name the style you want it to be written in. Now, let's look at an example. Write me a 200-word essay about nuclear fusion in style of J.K. Rowling. Here, instead of J.K. Rowling, can be any public figure, philosopher, writer, or even specific book, song, or any other written text. If you ever write anything, then you know that knowledge and experience are most important aspects of writing. This is where ChatGPT absolutely shines. It can help you learn and research anything really fast. Write me an outline about Harry Potter. And bam! We got a list of the most important aspects of the series. Now, elaborate on third point. As you can see, you can use ChatGPT to help you become a better writer. But what if you don't know how to write like a professional writer? Then we can ask ChatGPT for help. Replace my simple vocabulary with very advanced English. Yesterday it was raining and it was cold. I was sitting by the window, drinking tea and enjoying the view. And here is the answer. Now, write that in modern digital age kids style. As you can see, you can ask for different variations in any style. The last one is very useful, especially if you need to write something that you don't want to. Let me show you. Find some text you want to use. Let's open Wikipedia and copy this text about Harry Potter. Then write rephrase and paste the text in quotation marks. The program will rewrite it to make some kind of a new and original article. Of course, this could be obvious plagiarism, but we are not here to discuss ethics now. Finally, let's check how unique our article is with some online plagiarism checker. First, we check the Wikipedia article and then the ChatGPT. For the Wikipedia, it shows 98% plagiarized content, which is obvious. But for the ChatGPT rephrased article, it shows 100% unique content, which is unbelievable. So these are four different ways to use ChatGPT. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like and I see you next time.